I am Santosh Gaidankar. Today I am explaining the impact test. In that one, Charpy test. Aim to determine the impact strength of a given specimen. We have to determine the impact strength. Simultaneously, we have to determine the angle of rise and impact velocity. These are the apparatus required: pendulum type impact testing machine and vernier caliper. Observation: length of the pendulum will be 0.825 meter. In terms of mm, it should be 825 mm. Angle of drop is 140. The weight of the pendulum is 20.87 kg. Area of the specimen below the notch. Now, the notch will be in this way. This is the specimen. The diagram is drawn here. The area of the specimen you have to find out. How to find out the area? You have to measure this part. This will be 10. And area below the notch will be 5. If you multiply 10 divided by 5, it becomes 50 mm. Now how to measure? With the help of vernier caliper, you have to measure that part. First, measure the length here, or you can go for this part or this one. It becomes is 10 mm. Or if you want to go for here, no problem. This is 10. See here. The 0 is coinciding exactly at the 1. X0 is coinciding exactly at 1. 1 indicate here 10 mm. The 10 mm. The notch. Now here, if you measure the notch, area below the notch, here it will be 5 mm. 5 mm. That means here 0 exactly coincide with the 5. Multiply 10 into 5, it becomes 50 mm. The area for this specimen will be 50 mm. That is 10 into 5, it becomes 50 mm. Now we are going to conduct the impact test. Impact test. After conducting the impact test, we are substituting the values in order to find out the impact strength, angle of rise, and impact velocity. Today I am conducting the Charpy test. This is the impact test machine. In that one, the Charpy test. Charpy indicate the angle should be 140. This angle should be 140. If you compare, it should be 140. And striker contain ball pin hammer. This is nothing but ball pin hammer. You have to replace here. If it is a Charpy test, you have to consider ball pin hammer. If it is an ISO test, you have to consider forming hammer. This is the forming hammer. Now, the Charpy test, we are using this specimen for the Charpy test, and this is a U notch, and this has to be placed over the platform here in such a way that the U notch should be opposite end to the ball pin hammer. This is opposite end to the ball pin hammer. It should be in this way. Okay. Now, first you have to consider R1 value. Before considering the R1 value, you have to bring this needle to the maximum value. That is 300. We are checking this one for this Charpy test. For Charpy test, you have to go for outer scale. And one division is nothing but 2 joule. It is 2 joule. For ISO test, one division is nothing but 2 joule. But here you have to see this scale for ISO test. Now I am conducting the Charpy test. First I will release here. First remove the lock nut. Then release it. You will get R value. The R value is 0 here. R1 value is 0. We got the R1 value. Now bring this needle to the maximum, that is 300 joule. Now place the specimen. Before placing it, see, go for the safety lock here. Now place the specimen over the platform. Place the specimen. The specimen should be placed. The notch should be opposite end to the striking hammer. It should be placed in this way, opposite end. this part is should be very important to you. Next, release the lever, remove the safety lock, release the lever, the obtained value for R2 is 6 joule. In this way, you have to conduct the Charpy test.
We got the initial reading as 6. Sorry, initial reading will be 0 and the final reading is 6 joule. The angle of fall will be 140. The type of test is Charpy test here. Because the impact test contain two type, Charpy and Izod. Charpy and Izod. How to differentiate between Charpy and Izod based on the angle. Angle of drop is 140 in case of Charpy. And we have to place the specimen over the anvil horizontally. But in the case of Izod, we have to place similar to that of the I section. And the V notch has to be facing towards that of the farming hammer in the case of Izod test. In the case of Charping, the U notch should be placed exactly opposite to that of the striking hammer. Now we got the final reading, initial reading. Now substitute here. R is nothing but what? 6 minus 0, it is nothing but 6 joule, because the first reading is initial readings 0 here. The impact strength, how to find out the impact strength? This is the formula. 6 divided by area 50, it will be, the answer is 0.12 joule per mm square. We got the 0.12 joule mm square. Now we have to find out the angle of rise, that means beta. We have to find out how to find out the beta by using this. U is nothing but 6, substitute here 6. What is W? W is nothing but 20.8787 R in terms of mm. You have to take R in terms of mm. You have to write 825 cos beta minus cos alpha is nothing but 140 here. 140. 6 divided by 20.87 into 825. Bringing this one to this side, it becomes cos 140 and becomes cos beta. And this value will be minus 0.765 cos beta. Beta will be cos inverse minus 0.765. The angle will be 139.96 degree. This is the angle of rise. 139.96. This value should be approximate near to that of the 140. Next, you have to find out the impact velocity. Impact velocity 2. G is nothing but gravity. 9.81. R value in terms of meter you have to take. R value in terms of meter you have to take. 0.825 1 minus cos 140. If you calculate, the answer will be 5.346 meter per second. 5.346 meter per second. In this way, you have to find out the impact strength, angle of rise and impact velocity of a Charpy test. I am Santosh Gangkar. Thank you very much.